Computer Stress. Today we are going to see about transition and inner transition elements. First, introduction of transition elements and position of D-block elements in the periodic table. Electronic configuration of transition elements. Introduction of transition elements. What are transition elements? Metallic elements that have incompletely filled D orbital or F orbital in neutral or cationic state are called transition elements. Listen, students. Now, transition elements are as D orbital, incompletely D orbital, which means orbital has 1 electron or 2 electrons, 3 electrons like that. These are incompletely filled D shell or F subshell. Here further, we can understand about the transition elements and inner transition element is metallic element that have incompletely filled D orbital are called transition elements. Transition elements also known as D block elements. Similarly, metallic elements that have incompletely filled F orbital in neutral state and cationic state are called F-block elements or inner transition elements. Neutral means nothing but elemental state. Cationic is nothing but normal oxidation state. So these are elements are called transition and inner transition elements. This definition includes lanthanides and actinides also. IUPAC defines transition elements of element metal has a unfilled d orbital or which can give rise to cations with the incompletely filled d subshell. These are called transition elements. Generally, transition elements will occupy central position of the periodic table. The properties of transition elements are highly reactive elements of S block elements and P block elements. Certainly, P block elements are less reactive. Except group number 11, like copper, silver, gold, all are very soft nature. But all other transition elements are very hard and very high melting point. This is due to number of unpaired electrons. Whenever metallic elements, number of unpaired electrons increases means metallic character also increases. Next, important role of transition elements. Here, iron and copper play an important role in the development of human civilization. And the tungsten, chemical name of tungsten is wolfram, which is used in light bulb filaments. Titanium in manufacture of artificial joints. Molybdenum, these are used in bioplants used in power station. They are converted into high power steel. Next, the important of role in the living system, iron hemoglobin and magnesium chloride and cobalt in vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 is used for the production of red blood cells. Next, position of the D-block elements in the periodic table. We already learned in 11th standard in periodic classification the transition elements are present in group number 3 to group number 12. What is group? Group is nothing but the vertical columns are called groups. Horizontal rows are called as periods. Now the transition elements occupy group number 3 to 12 in the modern periodic table. Here 3D series element presenting 4th period. These elements are started from scandium to zinc. And 4D series elements is started from yttrium to cadmium. And 5D series element is started from lanthanum and hafnium to mercury. And 6D series elements presented actinide to copernicium. These are the 3D series elements and 4D series elements and 5D series elements, 6D series elements is like that. Except this zinc and cadmium, mercury, all other transition elements are incompletely filtered D subshell. Except zinc, cadmium, mercury are fully filled orbitals. So it is not considered transition metals, but the properties of transition elements of zinc and cadmium and mercury resembles with them. So zinc and cadmium, mercury are treated as transition elements. Next, T-block elements composed of 3D series. 3D series present in 4th period, like scandium to zinc. They have 10 elements. And 4D series elements present in 5th period, they started from yttrium to cadmium. They have 10 elements. The 3D series, also known as first transition series, 4D series is called a second transition series, and the 5D series transitions are called a third transition series. It started from lanthanum and hafnium to mercury. They have 10 elements. 6D series presenting 7th period elements started from actinium and rutherfordium to copernicium. They are also known as 4th transition series. Next, students, next, the group number 12 and the elements like zinc and cadmium and mercury do not have incompletely filled d orbital, but characters of transition metals resembles with them, so they are treated with the d block elements. Next, electronic configuration of d block elements. What is meant by electronic configuration? Electronic configuration is nothing but the electrons or distribution in an atom, in atomic orbital or molecular orbital. So here, how to write electronic configuration of transition elements? We are using two rules basically, the Auger principle and the Hund's rule. Auger principle is nothing but electrons are filled increasing order of energy level, like 1s2, 2s2, 3s, 4s, like that. And Hund's rule is nothing but electrons are singly occupied before doubled. So these two principles are based on the electron configuration of transition metals. Here, first of all, here first 4s orbital filled followed by 3d orbital. These things followed by the other transition elements are filled in electronic configuration. For example, scandium and titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, like that. Here, atomic number of scandium is 21. Configuration is 3d1, 4s2. Titanium 22. Electronic configuration of titanium is 3d2, 4s2. and vanadium, 23rd element, the electronic configuration of vanadium is 3d3 4s2. All these elements will follow the general rules, but except chromium does not obey the rule because the atomic number is 24. Actual electronic configuration is 3d4 4s2, but it is not stable configuration. Actual stable configuration is chromium as 3d5 4s1. This is stable electron configuration due to off-field stable. Whenever element off-field or filled-field stable means the electron configuration is more stable. Yes, students, here two exceptions characters are there. First one chromium, another one copper. Chromium and copper. Chromium actual electron configuration is, actual electron configuration of chromium is 3d5 4s1. Similarly, copper also 3d10 4s1, 3d10 4s2 is the electronic configuration of copper due to stable electron configuration of fully filled or off filled stable electron configuration. Yes, here this is d orbital. It has 5 electrons in singly occupied, means off filled stable. Similarly, d orbital has 10 electrons in orbitals is fully filled stable, here half filled stable, due to symmetrical distribution of electrons in and exchange of energy in electronic configuration. So, following this, due to reason, the general electronic configuration of d block element is noble gas, noble gas NS2, noble gas N-1, D1 to 10, and NS1 to 2. And the general electron combination of F block elements is noble gas N-2, F14, N-1, D1 to 10, and NS1 to 2. So this general formula we are using for 3D series elements. For example, here N is equal to 4 because 3D series elements present in 4th period. So here N-1, D1 to 10, and NS1 to 2. Here N is equal to 4 means we are getting 4-1, D1 to 10, and 4S1 to 2. We are getting 3D1 to 10, 4S1 to 2. Similarly, all these factors we follow the like a 4D series and 5D series and 6D series like that. Okay, students, I hope you understand my class. You should follow my classes. I will give some worksheet for you. Do this, we will meet next topic, metallic character of d block elements. Thank you so much. Okay, students, this is today worksheet I will give you. First question: what are transition elements? In give example, and what are the important role of transition elements, and write the electronic configuration of chromium and copper. Why group number 11 elements are so sorted, and why all transition elements hard and very high melting point. Do this worksheet. We will meet next class. Thank you, students.